wild turkeys. I saw two at first, but I guess the other one already got into the woods by the time I got the camera going.
What's up?
Yeah,
I'm just looking at some wild turkeys out there.
Oh, up here's peacocks.
Yeah, I've been here before like a year and a half ago, but these are actual turkeys.
Oh, yeah.
That's cool. Take care. Thank you. Well, I guess it's time to get to our final destination after, I guess, about a week and a half of traveling. Like, how much have you replaced what's here that was here?
So I can tell you exactly what came back well.
Well, what about this? Are any of these things original?
This is all from when you were here the last time.
You haven't added anything?
I haven't added anything to any of this.
So what's around this post, I'm pretty sure some of that has reseeded itself.
It had to.
It's good.
And you see the yellow? There's a
Rudbeckia.
Yeah, but that's
black-eyed Susan.
Black-eyed Susan. Yeah, which is probably racist, but that's all right.
Well, Rudbeckia, I think, is the technical term. What grows over here?
So I've seen some the Mexican
sunflowers.
Sunflowers came back last year.
No way. So they reseeded.
And then the cosmos kind of came back.
Yeah, they can reseed. I read about that.
But they haven't. This side hasn't done as well.
I'll check it out later. I'll check it. I like the black grass though that we put. It looks nice.
It really looks nice. And you know what I do? I take my sawzall in the spring and the fall.
Okay.
And I just cut it off.
Very. You could use it for mulch. Chop and drop, they call it.
Yeah. It really cleans up nice. That stuff works really well.
This is the handsome Studley Patrick.
Single Patrick.
Yes. And highly benevolent and kind. unappreciated. Oh, okay. So you got rid of two of these.
They died,
but this is nice.
This is the chase tree.
Butterfly?
No, the butterfly bush died.
This is the chase tree. I don't...
It dropped the leaves during the winter, but it survived.
Okay.
It was cold this winter. We had almost 30 days.
This survived?
Yeah.
Isn't that a bird of paradise?
Bird of paradise.
And it survived.
It's really well.
Probably its closeness to the to your house helped it.
Yeah,
it's radiating.
Cut the dead out of it. And this is
Amaryllis.
Amaryllis. They've done really well. Every time I buy one, I just stick it out here.
That should overwinter, no? Doesn't it overwinter? Because they overwinter up in Louisiana, northern...
Yeah, it does fine during the winter, and it bloomed a couple.
Why do you have to replace it?
No, I've been adding them.
Oh, so you have other ones.
Yeah, there should be other ones growing somewhere.
I see salvia. Was this original?
That's come up from what you did.
I love salvia. Isn't it pretty?
Yeah, and it draws bees. Bumblebees, especially.
What about hummingbirds?
Yes, I'll get hummingbirds when they start to arrive. They love the cracker, that firecracker, the white down there.
Oh, I don't know what that is.
Dude,
it looks nice.
So,
dude.
This is a finer grass that I got. It's done well. This blanket flower I love. It is awesome.
It is.
And you just cut it back and it comes right back and just reseed it. And some of this is getting to become weeds. I need to...
So what is this? I don't know what this is.
I don't either. It may be a weed.
Well, a weed is just whatever you don't want. You know?
Yeah. Well, there should be a rose. Okay, I planted this rose right here.
Okay.
And that's a Florida rose. It's a Florida native.
I think it needs to be cleared out for sunlight.
Yeah, I haven't trimmed for a while.
This isn't what was here before, is it?
No. What was
It was too far back. We had it too far back. Whatever
this,
it was.
There was something else there that died.
Okay.
And I got this. This is supposed to get tall, but it doesn't like anything below 50.
What kind of... Well, but you kind of have a microclimate here. It might be okay.
It stays okay.
Or you could drape something.
It survived the
winter. What kind of flower does it...
A yellowish flower.
And what is this? Don't tell me that that's a Malabar spinach. That's not Malabar spinach.
cranberry... Bleeding heart. It's called a
bleeding heart.
But it's Brazilian.
I didn't know they... Actually, I think I had just read that they can vine, but I've never seen them vining.
It did nothing last year when I planted it. It just sat there and sat there and sat there.
How tall did it get?
I mean, it was like maybe here.
Okay.
And then this year, after it froze down and came back, it's just been...
Dude, I love the salvias.
I need to get it tied up again, but...
All right, and here's...
Look at the blue. It blooms almost all summer.
Very nice.
And it's a bleeding heart.
That's pretty. They get bigger. They're just now budding, right?
Yeah, the buds don't get a lot bigger than that. They kind of stay small.
Is this Mexican heather or something? What's that called? Something Mexican. Something. I've seen it before.
Yeah, it's, I can't think of it right now. It died during the winter, and then this is a pagoda plant right here.
What is a pagoda plant?
They get a little bit more taller.
And then this has survived. I like that.
The pea, yeah. It needs, probably needs cut back. It looks really scrappy.
And what is this like some really hot peppers, or is that...
It's a weed.
Okay, you know what kind of weed this is? Because I'm pretty... It's related to tomatoes, but there's what do they call it? Deadly something.
Nightshade.
Isn't this deadly nightshade?
It kind of looks like it, but I'm not sure. Then I had a beautiful Hawaiian plants.
Okay.
The legs made out of. It died this winter. I don't think it's gonna come back at the base.
Does he? Oh, that's what you're talking about.
Yeah, that's what died. It was beautiful. Oh. But I had stole it from Disney. Broke a chunk off of Disney. And there's that
cranberry hibiscus.
We can't get rid of.
Here's a Mexican sunflower. It did by itself.
Yeah,
recently.
This has been kind of by itself. Here. Cool. I haven't done anything with this year.
There's some kind of lily right here. Day lily.
Yes, I put a day lily there.
Has this helped with your dogs? They still jump through.
No, they don't seem to be interested anymore. That's another hibiscus.
This is the Confederate. This is the Confederate hibiscus.
Yeah, it's a Florida native. And then
it looks like a rose, pink rose.
It's beautiful. It gets the most beautiful blooms on it. They don't last long. This is
lemongrass.
There's a little bit of that down that way too.
Where's your moringa tree?
Right there.
It's doing okay.
It's just coming back finally.
We could. Are the top ones dead? Like, should we just cut it?
I was gonna cut it off. I didn't get around to it yet.
Cool. Did you ever use it as supplements? But you know it's super nutritious.
Yeah, I was. You were eating it. I remember that. Didn't kill you. There's my olive tree. I planted that.
Okay.
I put some other things around it, but they all died.
You have no idea how fun this is for me to see. Is this jasmine?
Star jasmine, Confederate jasmine.
It smells nice.
Yeah, it's been blooming for quite a while. And this is. I tried to redo all this.
I like your trellis here. It's nice. You said you wanted to put something there.
Yeah, and it's got a really beautiful yellow rose on it. The rose just doesn't seem to be real healthy yet, but I haven't taken very good care of this.
Is this another possibly deadly nightshade?
Yeah, probably.
What is this?
These are called... I got these at Lowe's. They're Zone 9 Althea.
I don't know what it is.
I'm not familiar with it either. And I think this is an Althea right here, too, and it's doing better.
Althea.
I've been trying to plant more Zone 7 and 8 stuff because the 9 stuff doesn't seem to... That's a lily.
The 9 is going to be hit and miss.
Yeah, whether it survives.
Here it is. That's what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Hibiscus syriacus. I guess it's some kind of hibiscus from Syria? Or somewhere around there?
I don't know. Yeah, this is
Hello,
Texas
chickens.
Sage.
Texas sage. That's pretty.
Yeah, and actually it's doing really well in the heat over here, and so I may plant more of it.
The camera's not doing it justice. It looks really pretty.
It's a neat... I want something to kind of cover some of this up a little bit.
How tall is it?
6 to 8 feet, I think.
Nice. It looks like you have a lot of stuff over there, or is that just wild in your garden?
That's just all. It needs to be sprayed and killed and started over. The sea grapes died back completely this year. They're coming back very quickly.
Huh.
So the freeze got them. It was cold here this winter. We probably had close to 3 weeks where it was right at freezing.
Was that the late thing that came through Louisiana and everything?
Yeah, it hit it hard here.
So this you protected inside somehow?
I had it back underneath the...
Okay. Cool.
And then I had tried to plant some stuff here for some kind of hedge, and it got killed during the fall.
So sandy. It's amazing anything grows in this stuff.
Yeah. I was trying to buy...
Wow, this is completely wiped out.
Yeah, the winter was bad, man.
What did you have... Excuse me, you had something here before. What was
it? Yeah,
that?
I had like a
This is coming back.
Calorinda.
Sago palm?
No, those die too.
What is this?
This is a cardboard palm.
Okay.
I don't think
okay.
it's coming back yet.
It is coming back. What do you mean? That's clearly coming back.
I don't see anything green on it yet.
This is what it looks like when it's fresh. Okay. Yeah.
So it's coming back.
And it's even got a pup. It's got two pups. Three, four pups. Look.
That's a really cool.
Dude, you got several of these.
Yeah, I just need to blow this out.
You could separate those. It has like four pups.
They like you. These sea grapes just don't do well in the...
Here's more of your cardboard.
Yeah, and then this is a Calicendra.
What is that?
Cassia.
I don't know what that is.
It gets big, and it gets beautiful yellow flowers on it.
Huh. Here you go. What is this called again? I forgot. I like these.
Thornellus.
Thornellus.
Yeah, it needs trimmed back, but it's... The butterflies just love it. It's done really well. The other one it's at in. This is pretty much a hot mess.
Did you have such a beard last time? It's nice.
I don't remember.
It looks good on you. And what about that trellis over there? Anything on it?
There's nothing on it right now.
So we gotta fix that, sir.
Yeah, so that... Why are you harassing us? You have ate it... already.
They want attention.
That's what they want. They want petted.
That's so cute.
They says, you're not dad. Who are you?